Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, my name is Macy and I am a full-time fashion reseller. I sell on sites like Poshmark, eBay, Mercari, and my own website, blueconsignment.com. If you are interested in reselling content, that is what my channel is all about. So feel free to hit that subscribe button down below and tap the notification bell so that you know next time I put out new videos. Okay, with all of that said, in today's video, I am going to be taking you guys through TJ Maxx with me, picking out things to resell, so buying them for a low price on clearance, and then selling them for much more online, hopefully. That's the goal anyways. But I'm going to show you guys what I picked up and if anything has sold, because I did this 2 months ago.
Editing Macy here, stopping on this goofy photo of my face in order to update that it was actually 4 months ago.
During their Yellow Tag clearance sale. So this is one of the best sales that they hold during the year. But this one is delayed so that I can show you guys what actually sold out of what I picked up, and then you'll know what things flip fast in, which might take a little bit longer to sell, but will probably still sell for a decent profit. So I hope that you all enjoy.
First find is a joie thick knit sweater. I am going to be showing the comps for each item on the side there. There was only one comp for $80. This sweater was on clearance for $22, so I did decide to get it. It ended up selling in a little over 1 week on Poshmark for $80, which left me with a $42 profit. The next find was this sheer lace tank top by Laundry by Shelley Segal. It was a size 1X, so pretty good size, but I could only find one comp for it for $22, and it was on clearance for $8, originally $128, great price, but I would only get like $10 in profit if I ended up selling it for $22, so I decided to pass. Another item found in the plus size section was this Philosophy, kind of a suede feeling floral jacket slash cardigan. Super pretty, but comps just weren't that great. You can see anywhere between $20 to $35, so at $22 on clearance it just wasn't worth the price. Next I found a Lucky Brand open front fringe patterned sweater in a size 1X. Lucky Brand is one of those brands you have to be really careful picking up because not a lot of styles resell for a lot of money, and this was just too expensive to pick up even on clearance at $22. My next find was this super cute gray ribbed cardigan sweater. It was such a soft material, oh my gosh. And it is a very trendy style. Comps were decent, anywhere from $30 to $60-ish dollars. So I did decide to pick this up at $15. It sold within 1 day of listing on Poshmark for $48, which left me with a profit of $23.40. Another 7 for All Mankind find was this puff shoulder chambray look long sleeve top. I cannot find any comps for this exact style. However, I know that puff shoulder is trendy and this was only $12 on clearance, so I decided to give it a chance at a size large. It has not sold yet. I then went over to the pants and jeans section and found these AG, the Noton crop pants. I was really debating on these because comps did not look great. The exact same pair had sold for $20. However, this is a carpenter style pant, which can do well, and I've had good luck with AG in the past, but at $15, I did decide to pass on these. However, a week later, I came back to this same TJ Maxx, and they had been marked down to $10, at which point I did decide to pick them up. Unfortunately, I did not notice some discoloration on the pants until I went to list them, so I did end up letting them go for $20 on Poshmark. They sold within a month and a half of listing, and I made a $6 profit. The next find were these pair of Hudson Blair jeans. They were $25 on clearance, and Hudson is one of my favorite brands to resell. However, when looking through the comps, the dark wash style of these jeans just didn't seem to be going for as much as some of the other washes, and at $25, I just couldn't justify the price. The next find was this pair of Calvin Klein houndstooth pattern skinny pants. Super cute. Oh my gosh, if I worked in an office, I would be all over these. But comps are just not that great for Calvin Klein for a lot of styles. Sometimes it can be good, but a lot of times it'll be like this, hovering right around $20, which makes the $16 clearance price definitely not worth it. I then was super excited to find a whole bunch of mother jeans. They were all the same style, the looker crop style. However, they were in really small sizes. Almost all of them were a size 25, and they were all priced at $39. And comps just didn't seem to be that good for this particular style, and especially not in this wash, so I did decide to leave it behind. It actually ended up going on clearance even more for $25 a few weeks later. I still left it behind, and I kind of regret that. I wish I would have picked up at least one or two to give them a shot, but oh well. I then went over to the sweater section and found this cupcakes and cashmere zebra open front cardigan. Really nice material. I debated on this one because there was only one comp at $40. However, I found more than one of this sweater, at which point I decided to go for it because I could make one listing and then get two items listed, both of which are still available for sale. Next find was this Free People collared oversized lavender colored sweater. I had the hardest time capturing the color of this sweater. Oh my gosh. The camera that I use for listing just completely rejects all shades of purple for some reason. But this was only $15 on clearance. I didn't even have to look up comps. No brainer pickup here. It sold for $45 on Poshmark and I ended up profiting $21. It took about 2 months to sell. Next find was this mock neck, thick knit ribbed sweater from Cupcakes and Cashmere. The comps were kind of all over the place for sweaters and I couldn't find this exact style, so I did decide to give it a chance. They were only $12 each. I got a bunch of them. None have sold yet, but I'm hopeful for next fall. Another Cupcakes and Cashmere find was this sweater vest with an open front and fringe hem. I really love the cable knit detail on this. I couldn't find any exact comps, and at $16, I decided to pass. However, I came back a few weeks later, and they were marked down to $12, and I found two of them, at which time I did decide to pick them up. I have sold the extra small one. It sold on eBay for $62.94. I profited $32.64 on that one. It sold in less than a month. The large is still available. This colorful tie-dye champion sweatshirt I thought might be good because tie-dye is trendy. However, comps were kind of all over the place and I just couldn't get myself comfortable with spending the $12 clearance price on the sweatshirt. I wasn't sure how it would perform, so I decided to pass on it. I was excited to find this Free People Intimately sheer mesh long sleeve top. I know that tops that look like this can do well in general. However, I was hoping to find comps for specifically Free People Intimately, which I unfortunately could not, so I had to take a chance on it at $7 on clearance. Unfortunately, it did have a little stain on it, so I decided to let it go for $15 on Mercari. It took about 2 months to sell, and I made a $7 profit. This Seven for All Mankind puff shoulder long sleeve top is just like the other one that I showed you earlier, the chambray look one. I decided to get this one as well, just for easy listing purposes, and it was the same price at $12. It hasn't sold yet. This Joie sweatshirt I was considering because the price was marked down all the way to $10. However, when looking up comps, I could only find a few of this exact sweatshirt and they were only going for somewhere between $15 to $20. That didn't seem worth it, so I decided to pass on this. That's why it's so important to look up comps, because even if it's a great brand and a great price, it doesn't mean that it's worth picking up to resell. My last find in the sweater section was this Misa light blue puff sleeve sweater, and comps varied very much for this sweater on Poshmark, so I wasn't sure what I was gonna get for it. It was my first time finding Misa and I wanted to give it a chance. Those over 200 comps looked really good to me, so I did decide to get it, and it ended up selling on Poshmark for $77. I paid $15 for it and I profited $45. It took 1 day to sell. Madewell 10-inch high-rise jeans are one of my favorite things to pick up if I can find them at TJ Maxx, especially if they're a good price. These were marked down to 16 on clearance, and they are a plus size 36, so I did decide to get them. I am very surprised that they are still available for sale, but I do have them priced pretty high at 72. These 7 for All Mankind Kimmy straight leg jeans, I had a little bit of a difficult time deciding whether to pick up or not at $15, just because comps were pretty low for the most part. This style has been around for a really long time, so a lot of these comps are for much older pairs of Kimmy straight jeans, which I did keep in mind whenever I was deciding. And I did decide to get them. They ended up selling about 2 months later for $59.44 on eBay. With a $15 cost of goods, I ended up with a profit of $25.28. I then came across these Lane Bryant girlfriend crop jeans with some patchwork on the front. Comps, once again, did not seem amazing, so at $10 on clearance, I decided to pass on these. The next find was this pair of Talbots velvet ankle length pants. Comps looked pretty good, hovering right around $45 there, and they were only $8 on clearance, so I decided to get them. They have not sold yet, but they have gotten a lot of attention. Another Talbots find that I did decide to pick up was this tweed skirt. It was only $6 on clearance, and it also has not sold yet. The last section I decided to check out before leaving TJ Maxx was the men's section, and specifically I looked at the jeans and pants. I found these nice American Eagle skinny leg flex jeans, but they were in a very small size, a size 26, and comps did not look great for that size. But if it was a larger size, I totally would have got it for the price. One of my favorite things to find in the men's jeans section are Lucky brand jeans. If I can find them for $20 or under on clearance, I almost always pick them up. These were a great size at a size 38-32, and they sold very quickly after listing within a few days on Mercari for $46. I paid $20 for them, which left me with a profit of $19.77. I have also sold the same style of jeans on eBay this year for a profit of $18, and on Poshmark this year for a profit of $37. Here is another example of a pair of Lucky brand jeans that I have picked up and sold. These are the 121 slim straight style. They sold on Poshmark within 1 day of listing for $50. I paid $20 for them, so I had a profit of $20. I sold a larger size of this same style about a month after listing, and that brought in a profit of $24 on Poshmark. And the last item I wanted to show you guys were these pair of 410 Lucky brand khaki pants that I picked up for $15. They sold on eBay within 2 weeks of listing for $61.44, which left me with a profit of $26.57. So even the khakis can do well.
Thank you all so much for watching. I hope that you enjoyed that thrift with me and that you found some value in it and know what to pick up a little bit better for next time. If you did enjoy the video, please hit that like button down below. It really supports my channel. If you want to see more reselling content from me, hit that subscribe button and tap that notification bell so that you know next time I put out a new video. I do not have a consistent schedule yet, so those notifications are the best way to know anytime I put out new content. Thank you all so much, and I hope that you all have a wonderful rest of your day, everybody. Bye!